this is Turkey and we're gonna have our first meal at Simit Sarai.
What?
This thing. How is it? It's either called a doner or donor meat. How is it? Sab theek? So guys, the reason I'm here in Turkey is I'm here for the Misa Mor getaway. I'm gonna be shooting some really pretty outfits. Begin from the airport itself, so this is so exciting. What's up guys? So we got done with our day shoot today and we're gonna head out for some night shoot later on. But right now we're gonna have some food to eat. Chai, this is what they call it in Turkish. People usually welcome you with this even when you like visit them, like a symbol of hospitality. The meat is delicious. It's difficult being a vegetarian, especially when you come to a country like Turkey. So make sure you carry your own Doritos and chips. Hey guys, this is day two to our trip in Turkey. That's Kanan, that's Shivam, and that's Ashna. I have some quick breakfast before we head to the shoot location, which Karan has counted for really
I'm
well.
I'm on Larissa's vlog. So sexy, she looks even better than Misa Mor.
That's true.
She looks much better in person.
That's true.
And she's a gem of a person.
Oh.
It is not possible.
Tambi Cafe, and I'm having this toast with meat and cheese, and that's the meat. Thanks. What's your name?
Cheese.
Okay.
I want the cheese.
This is a Turkish coffee, and this is some piece of chocolate here. Turkish coffee is really very popular in Turkey, like the chai. Hey, so we are at this location. I don't know how to pronounce it. The names here are very difficult to pronounce, so please excuse me for that. Ooh, those legs. So we just picked some coffee and Nutella from this shop and we are at our shoot location. This is what it looks like when we are shooting outdoors. I don't usually do a lot of this, but Ashna is very used to this. I'm not really used to a lot of shooting outdoors. Was either going to love you or they're going to hate you.
They're going to hate me for sure.
They won't hate you. You wouldn't hate Kanan. You cannot hate Kanan. Kaya, he's ill. Kalaya. Cigarette. There's a no smoking board somewhere over there. And Grishma thought that's the name of the restaurant. So the name of the restaurant is Kizil Kayala. So we are at this location to shoot, and look who I found here. Hey. Hey, kitty. Hey. Hey guys, so we are at a location to shoot and I found a fellow YouTuber. What's your name?
Hey guys, I'm Julian.
Julian, that's Julian. And he has, what kind of a channel do you have?
I'm talking about my spiritual journey.
Oh.
And what helped me to reach this point where I am right now.
Okay. Yeah. That's great, that's great. I saw him sitting right there and filming himself and I guessed that he was a YouTuber because he had a mic on his camera and I'm like, this is definitely a YouTuber. Nice to meet you, Julian.
Nice to meet you too.
It's day 5 and we are heading out for some
shopping!
So right now we are at Historia Mall. So we are shooting at this location. We found some really cool people here who are taking pictures with us, and I cannot understand what they're saying, but they're really happy to see us. So and especially this guy and this guy.
From Antalya, from Giresun, from Kayseri.
All of y'all, Güzenşil.
Yes.
Güzenşil.
Yes.
Yes.
Hindi.
See?
About traveling to different places with different cultures is the new people that you meet, and it's so interesting to make conversation with these people, and I've quite learned some words from Turkish and I try to use those. I also use the Google Translate, and that's what makes it so interesting to be around here in Turkey. I've been trying to make conversation with almost everyone, so whoever we're interacting with, I try to speak to them in Turkish, and it's so much fun when they realize that you're making an effort, and you know, then they want to speak more about where you're from, and they get really excited when you say you're from India. So it's so nice. It's so it's very overwhelming in a very nice way, and I kind of love it. I love it. And Turkish is a very interesting language to learn. It's pretty simple as well. So I wish I could stay here longer, or I would definitely love to come back here and learn the language. And but I'm gonna miss this place. It's so beautiful, and the culture is different, and the people are very welcoming. You cannot always trust everyone around, but it's always so welcoming, and like everybody's welcoming. Everybody's very, very warm, and I'm loving the weather here, loving everything about this place. I don't want to go back. Very funny thing just happened. I found this PO on the road.
It's because of y'all that have come to the road.
So we are at Balat. It's supposed to be Istanbul's most colorful place, and we're going to be shooting here. But before that, it's time for some Mussels. Yeah, what's it?
Robin. Turkish media.
Media?
Yes.
I wanna eat it.
That's
what they do. Going in my mouth.
So it's our last day here in Turkey, in Istanbul, and we are walking towards Grand Bazaar.
And when I say we, I mean
we,
me and Shivani. And we've been walking for like good 10 minutes now, and it's all uphill, so it's so tiring. Also, the shops here are shut. It's 11 o'clock and the shops are still shut. People are opening up their shops. But it's very surprising when you come from a very busy city altogether, although I don't stay in Bombay. But still, like, the shops that open near our place open at around 8, and this is very difficult to digest. How do they function? Look at the shops. They're still shut. We're the only ones walking through this lane. And Grand Bazaar is one of the world's largest indoor markets, and it's like a network of indoor souks. It's looking for the place on Google Maps. Ani's tired. At least we are losing out
all the French fries
we had last night. Like, we've been having so much of French fries, and
we have French fries with every meal.
Hey guys, so we are very unfortunate because Grand Bazaar is shut on Sundays, but we found another like a similar looking place just next to it. So we are walking around and we don't really know the difference, so it doesn't really make any difference to us. So I picked some crockery already, which I'm gonna show once I reach Bombay. And there are a lot of beautiful things here as well. There are spices and there is like beautiful crockery even here. This is what?
Lemon, mint, eucalyptus.
This is lemon, mint and eucalyptus tea, and the one Shivani is having is pomegranate. And this, the aroma of this tea is so strong, like it hit me so hard. It's a very good tea for waking up, I guess. I'm gonna taste it. It's like right into my soul.
How many fish you need?
One.
I need one more.
Something else. Let's
try this.
Real definition of waking up with the tea.
Turkish delight, pomegranate, honey, and pistachio.
Yeah.
Can we take it on flight?
Yeah. I really love the pomegranate tea as well. It's a sweet made of pomegranate and has no sugar. It's only made with honey. And what is it called? The name of it?
Turkish delight.
Turkish delight. So this tea is called love tea as... and what is this?
Relax tea. After
relax.
After the life for sleep.
Oh. So that and this is?
Mixed green tea.
That's mixed green tea.
Oh, antioxidant.
Antioxidant.
Pomegranate.
Oh, this is the one. I really like this. Which was the mint one?
Mint?
Yeah.
This one. Lemon, mint and eucalyptus.
Oh, this is damn strong. How much is this?
350 kilograms.
Oh.
1 kilo. You don't have to buy kilo.
Okay, yeah.
Small quantity.
It's too strong though. Did you buy anything? You all bought all these?
Yeah.
Separate things.
Yeah, mixed media. 83 lira ho raha hai
iska. She's getting all these different sweets.
Okay.
I think I like it.
Yeah.
This more.
Because I told you. I just told her. You know. Maybe she had to think about this because it has more yellow.
Hey guys. So we just done with our shopping on our last day. Unfortunately, we couldn't shop at Grand Bazaar because it was shut since it's a Sunday. So if you're coming to Turkey, if you ever plan your Grand Bazaar visit on a Sunday, don't, because it's shut usually on Sundays. And I think we picked a lot of crockery. We picked some Turkish chai, Turkish coffee, some spices, some Turkish delights, some more crockery. And the best part about shopping in Turkey, especially at these markets, are the cute shopkeepers. We don't know if it's going to fit into our bags. And one thing about shopping in Istanbul, Turkey, one tip that I could give you is come with your travel light, so you can carry some. If you're like a lot into crockery and all those things, then please travel light, and so you make space for your crockery.
Yapma bunu.
Delirttim seni, delirttim.
Mix.
Chocolate.
Yalan olsun ki çocuğum. Hey! Ha? Şimdi toplanıyor. Hıp!
Bakalım bağırtma kalemle.
Aha! Hay maşallah! Extra for you. Böyle karşılık vermesi lazım bu işe. Bu çok hoşuna gitti.
Just fool the F out of us.